Human society is aging. It is associated with changes in molecular composition within us. However, it is unknown whether the changes in these molecules are drivers or passengers of aging. My lab investigates how aging affects diseases as we age and tries to identify cures to mitigate these circumstances. So in our quest to identify metabolic networks that underlie age-associated diseases, we performed a metabolomic analysis in a specific nutrient deficiency. This metabolomic analysis showed that one of the most dramatically down-regulated molecules in the screen was taurine. Taurine is an atypical molecule and is present in abundant amount in our tissues. It is produced within our bodies primarily through liver and some other organs, and it can be obtained through animal-based diet and nutrition. Taurine is not a new molecule. It was identified more than 200 years ago. In 1950s, pet foods were introduced into the society. This led to an increased incidence of diseases in the pets. The research into this process led to the discovery in 1975 that retinal degeneration or blindness in cats is caused by taurine deficiency. In the present study, we show that taurine abundance declines with age in several species. This led us to investigate whether taurine concentration that declines with aging is a driver or a passenger of aging. To address the role of taurine in aging, we orally fed taurine to middle-aged C57BL6J mice because we knew taurine levels were low in them. Taurine fed mice of both sexes survived longer. The average lifespan increase in females was about 12% and in males was about 10%. A meaningful anti-aging therapy should not only increase lifespan but also health span. Taurine fed mice acquired less body weight, they had reduced adiposity, increased energy expenditure, increased muscle strength, neuromuscular coordination, reduced anxiety, increased memory, better glucose and insulin tolerance, and their immune phenotype was enhanced. To find out whether these observations hold true in primates, we next performed a monkey intervention study. This analysis showed that taurine-supplemented monkeys had better functioning of a variety of organ systems, including reduced adiposity, better bone density, better glycemic index, and a better functioning of the immune system. This led us to next perform a association analysis in a large epignorfol cohort of 12,000 people to see whether changes in taurine levels are associated with changes in health of human beings. This showed that deficiency of taurine, hypotaurine, and acetyltaurine, three metabolites in the same pathway, leads to poor health, such as increased incidence of diabetes, hypertension, obesity, and liver damage. We found that a bout of exercise in humans led to an increase in taurine, hypotaurine, and acetyltaurine. The results are very straightforward, although it took us 11 years to do this study. Taurine abundance declines with aging in several species, and a reversal of this decline increases healthy lifespan in mice and worms and health span in monkeys. This identifies taurine deficiency as a driver of aging in these species. Next step of this research is us humans. Taurine has no known toxic effects, although rarely used in the concentrations used here, can be administered orally and affects all the major hallmarks of aging. Although it is difficult to say at the present time whether taurine supplementation is going to be an anti-aging therapy, based on our studies in several species and our intervention in monkeys, it is reasonable to test it at least.